So it's going through. So I'm going through my box of wood. I've got seasoned wood here, and I found a really nice piece of laburnum. Okay, so you can see there with the sapwood and the heartwood. You can see the beautiful grain it has. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to try and incorporate this into this. Okay, so a big piece of wood. Now laburnum is really hard, and I want this video to be slightly different from the other ones I've done. So I'm not just going to be making a spoon like a wood out in the woods. I've got my linisher here, so this has been done so far with my linisher, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make this spoon using the linisher, and then I'll bring you lot along for the journey, and we can see how this turns out. This is an experiment. I've never done something like this before, but it's going to be fun. So let's just see what we turn up with. I mean, I'm hoping that even if this doesn't work, I'll still end up with a really nice spoon out of this. So, but first time I've made a spoon using the linisher. Just change the camera, see what I'm talking about. There you go. It's the first time I've even made a spoon using this. But I'll bring you along for the ride. I need to be careful with the amount of sawdust, because you can see all this sawdust here. So I need to be, sorry, bring it to the camera so you can at least see what I'm talking about. See all the sawdust. So I need to be a bit careful of the camera, but I'll bring it in and video show you through various stages, and then take the camera out of the way. Right, see you in a few minutes. Smoky work. Okay, so here is my spoon. Okay, so far you can see the lovely contrast from the sapwood and the heartwood, and you know, once I get this oiled up, you can see the grain, the tight grain in it. I've got some sapwood on the top. So that's my spoon. So I finished the spoon, and I just wanted to share with you what we come up with. And here it is. So here's my spoon, and you can see this is this bit of the sapwood I managed to leave on. Okay, it comes around, you can see the sapwood at the back there. Now this laburnum, you know, got a nice profile on the handle. Laburnum is a really, really hard wood. Carving this bowl out, you know, just with a spoon knife, you know, the curved knives that we're using, it's just hard work. It takes a long time, hours and hours of sanding, but I'm really, really pleased with this spoon. I think it's a beautiful piece of work, and yeah, I'm glad I didn't cut it up to put the antler on. You know, the one with the antler, it has a similar effect with that contrasting grain. But this is a much lighter spoon. This is still very heavy. There's still a lot of wood in this. I haven't carved the bowl super thin. It's probably still 5mm thick at the bottom here. I could make it thinner and just carve the bowl out more. Or I could actually sand the bottom flatter to thin it. So I don't know, I may do, I may not. I quite like having this band here. If I take it thinner, the dark wood will go straight through the back here as well, and I'll have two white lobes. But I quite like this sort of shape. The other nice thing about this with the grain is I had two knots in it. I'm trying to get so the camera can see them for you. So there was a knot here and a knot here, and I left them in and obviously just sanded through it. I mean, I use the linisher for doing a lot of this, apart from the final shaping, but you now get this really nice rings, and you can see the grain coming through here. So it just turns out to be a really, really nice piece of wood, and you can see how tight the grain is in it. So yeah, really, really pleased with this spoon. One of my I think one of my best that I've made so far. And I don't keep many spoons either. When I make my spoons, generally they're when I'm out in the woods with a group of friends and stuff like that, and you sort of whittle around the fire and things like that, and then, I don't know, just give them away or whatever. This one here, the one with the deer hoof on it, is the one I use most of the time. I mean, this stays in my pack. I made this for me as my camp spoon, my fireside spoon, whatever you want to call it. This is quite light. I mean, if the antler was off it, it'd be a very light spoon. If it was just all cherry, it'd be super light, but it's a nice novelty factor. So I think all three of these, I think are just going to be kept in my collection. So I just want to keep updated, and I'll talk to you in the next video.